Hello, welcome to TelecomTV. My name is Tony Chan, and with me today is Chongfeng Xie from China Telecom. Mr. Xie, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me here.
As part of China Telecom, what do you think is the key success factors for commercially deploying NFV? And also, how do you see open source solutions playing into the deployment?
I think that the NFV deployment, the time for NFV deployment has come. One of the major factors for NFV deployment is how to improve the competitive power of operators. There's two meanings. The first one is how to improve the speed of the service to market, that is service agility, which is very important for operators, especially when they have the fierce competition from other carriers and OTT. So that will be very important. The second one is how to reduce the cost of network construction. Mm-hmm. That is, reduce the cost of CAPEX and OPEX. We have made some estimation and analysis. We found that NFV is very effective for some specific use cases, such as low bit rate, long-lived applications such as VoIP and VPDN and ITMS. And so I think that will be the business drivers for NFV deployment. Okay. Of course, regarding to the open source, I think open source will be very important for NFV deployment, because with open source, network operators can set up network quickly to meet the market requirement. And of course, hopefully, I think open source can help operators to reduce the cost to some extent.
Because we're at this event organized by the OPNFV, which has been founded for 3 years.
Yeah.
But during that period, there's a lot of different open source solutions and projects that has emerged on different levels of the network stack. As an operator, how do you manage all the different open source communities and projects and technologies?
Yeah, I think that's a very good question. Firstly, I think that OPNFV has done a great job to push forward the NFV deployment globally during the last several years. We all know that NFV is based on open source, but there are multiple open source projects. No one open source project is responsible for integrate and compose all this piece of software together. So how to make them fit together and to form an end-to-end NFV solution is very important. So to solve this problem, OPNFV bring all the upstream open source together and to do the continuous integration, continuous test, and the continuous delivery, so it can provide end-to-end NFV solutions to operators. So we can set up the NFV network easily. So I think that OpenNFV has done a great job during the last several years.
Okay. Mm-hmm. There has been some discussion about security within the open source community. Obviously, security is very important within a carrier environment. Do you see security being integrated within the open source community?
Yeah, of course. Security is utmost important for operators. With NFV, there is not a challenge of security. But I hope that with NFV, we can provide some new features. For example, we can set up a VNF instance easily by lifecycle measurements in case of failure. A new VNF instance can be recreated to avoid any attack. So that will be very interesting. The second one is that the VNF security depend on the underlying infrastructure. So we need some tools to verify the security of the underlying infrastructure to make them even secure than traditional network. So we hope that the hypervisor should be verified in advance. Of course, I think that the security can also be guaranteed from the IP perspective. We all know that the anti-DDoS system has been widely deployed in legacy network. So I think that this kind of system can also be deployed in NFV networks to counterpart any DDoS attack. And some other systems such as firewalls can also be needed to be deployed to avoid any attack. And some ports in VNF can also need to be closed to avoid any evasion. So this is a very complicated work to do.
So do you think the industry can do more to facilitate the integration of security within an NFV environment? Do you think maybe perhaps we need another open source community for security?
Well, I do think there's need another group or committee to the security. I think this can be another working group of OPNFV to do the security. Maybe this has some kind of organization like this, but I think it can be done within the framework of OPNFV.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Going back to OPNFV and its core mission to help carriers, I guess, test and verify NFV components and technologies for deployment, how does China Telecom go about testing NFV solutions and environments before it deploys the network?
Yeah, I'm from the China Telecom Beijing Research Institute, which is R&D, R&D department of China Telecom. So test and evaluation is our main task. So right now we have done a lot of tests of NFVs. Right now we mainly carry out the test for VBNGs, virtualized BNGs for broadband network. Mm-hmm. So we mainly focus on the function test performance, HA, which means high availability, and the life cycle management, etc. We also carry out the test of interoperability between VNF and the manual, mm-hmm. So from different vendors. Yes, our test mainly focus on commercial deployment. Yes, but another fact that I think is very important is openness and decoupling, which means that because that NFVs adopted a layered architecture, so different layers can be provided by different vendors, which requires that the layers should be decoupled from each other, so which can create a ecosystem for different layers.
And how has OPNFV actually helped you with using these tests and verifying some of the solutions?
As I have mentioned, OPNFV has done a good job for the test. As far as I know, they adopted a method called a continuous integration, continuous test. They also test NFV in many cases, scenarios. So I think all this work will be very helpful for operators to reduce our workload, so make the NFV mature as fast as possible.
One of the hottest topics today is 5G. Obviously, many people are looking at 5G as a very revolutionary development of, yeah, of the network. From your perspective, how do you see 5G and the open source community coming together, because there's a lot of talk that 5G will require a lot of virtualized infrastructure?
Frankly speaking, I'm not a 5G guy. As far as I know, 5G is still in the stage of standardization, which has not been finished yet. But I think that NFV will play important roles in the future 5Gs. So from this regard, I think that 5G will share the same principles, methodology with other network, other NFV network. For example, they will share the same underlying infrastructure, NFVI and the MANO. Hopefully, so I think that open source and something like that will play important roles in the 5G era. Meanwhile, continuous integration, continuous test, continuous delivery. We also can make the different software fit together to meet the requirement of future networks, including 5G. Mm-hmm. So I'm very optimistic about the open source for 5G.
Being based in China and working with the community here for open source, have you noticed any specific cultural or approach differences when it comes to working with the open source community globally?
I have been in this area for a long time. I have my feelings. I think the major difference about the China, about China, is that the market is very big. Yeah, we have 31 provinces. We have several provinces, and also we all noticed that NFV has many scenarios, use cases. For example, virtualize the BNG, VEPC, VCP, VFirewall, etc. of network on demand. So I think that NFV will have very big space in China. Another fact is that there's not a city guy, ID guy in China, and they are very young, they're very energetic. And so the research, development, and the deployment in China is very, the environment is very good. So they can provide enough human resource for NFV SDN deployment. Recently, the three major operators in China, major operators in China, has announced their network transformation scheme. For example, China Unicom, China Telecom, China Mobile, respectively. So they can provide all this network strategy is based on SDN, NFV, and cloud computing. So I think that they can provide more opportunity to NFV. Yeah, of course we have a lot of challenges. Yeah, okay.
Can you elaborate on some of the challenges?
Yeah, the major challenge for us is to manage and operate NFV network, because NFV is adopted a layered architecture, and the different layers require different skills. But right now, most of the guys in operators are many city guys. They have little or no knowledge of the IT. So they need to learn the new IT technologies. They need to learn computing. They need to learn the hypervisor. They need to learn the VM, etc. So which is a big challenge for them. Another one is that the current workflows of the network operators need to be changed to meet the convergence of IT and the CT. So I think that maybe there's a long way to go. So that's my understanding.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.